Welcome back, everybody, to another saucy edit. Today, I'm going to head to Josh's house, and me and him are going to go down to a local creek. There's a few around here, and we've been trying to fish as many of them as we can. And we're going to this one. A buddy from my work told me that there's small sawguy running through this creek right now. And Chris Boulaw is actually fishing this creek in some of his older videos, if you guys watch him. I'll leave a link to his channel below. He used to get a Miami around here. That's where I live, and that's where I'm going. And he would fish in some of the creeks around here, and he's fishing this creek before, and it's actually a pretty good creek. There's some good-sized largemouth in this creek and smallmouth, and my friend said there's sawguy in here. So we're going to go. Hopefully, we're going to target some smallmouth, and then we're going to see if we can catch some of these small sawguy, because I've never caught one before, and I think it would be really cool. But I'd like to thank you guys for watching and enjoy the rest of the video. What's up, bud?
What's up?
Let's just take yours because I don't know if she's got enough gas in her right now. Alright guys, we just got to Josh's house and me and him are gonna head down to the creek and hopefully we've got some nice.
Is it for deadly nightshade? Cause I was filled with poison, but blessed with beauty and rage. Jen told me that it hit me and it felt like a kiss. Jen brought me back and moved me away with a kiss.
Wasn't on, but me and Josh are here at the pond, not pond, we're at the creek, and there's a bridge right here. That's where we're gonna start, and my friend said that there was a sawguy running in this creek right now, so if we get lucky we might catch one of those, but the main target is gonna be some good sized smallmouth, so hopefully we get on some. Guys, Josh is the first to hook up of the day.
We caught it on a whopper fly, top water. Nice bass, smallmouth.
Heck yeah, let's get back.
There he goes.
Sweet. Thank you.
Oh my gosh, dude. Oh, that thing was big. It was like 3-pounder probably. I think it was a largemouth. I couldn't really tell. Oh, oh. There we go. Oh my gosh, that's a big smallmouth. Big smallmouth. Not huge, but it's pretty good. Oh, dude, come videotape me with my camera. All right, guys. So we've been walking in this creek now for about a mile and a half, and I finally pulled out a really nice smallmouth for a creek. It's getting washed off real quick. He's pretty color, nice brown. He's about 2 pounds. And we're gonna get him back in the water here. Josh, you wanna come videotape real quick?
Yeah.
We just caught a beautiful smallmouth. I caught on the white whopper plopper. And it's about 2 pounds, nice, pretty brown. And we're gonna get him back in the water here. Sweet, that feels great. Oh, there's another one, dude. I don't think it was as big. It was still a really nice one. I hate messing with these things, so I always make sure they can't move. Alright, so we just caught a smallmouth out of this spot. It was a little bit bigger than this bass, but for a creek, this is a pretty good sized largemouth. He's about 1 pound. We're gonna let him back in the water. Nice and easy. See ya, bud. Sweet. Oh my goodness. All right, guys. So we've been walking about an hour through the creek. Our legs are all torn up. It's pretty ridiculous. And here we just came out of the creek onto this bridge. You can see the creek down here. It gets deep right there. So we had to come out of the creek. It gets deep over here and over there. So we had to find another way to get around because there's no way we're walking through that deep spot. So hopefully we're gonna try to get to this swell in the creek. It has like 6-pound bass in it. And we're gonna see if we can hopefully get there without getting killed by some crazy person on this river. 'Cause I was filled with poison, but blessed with beauty and rage. Jim told me that it hit me and it felt like a kiss. Jim brought me back. Okay.
It's a US highway, man.
Go okay.
Ahead.
Yeah, thank you. You too. Guys, so it took us about an hour since the last video you guys saw me, and we just got to the pond in the creek we were talking about. So the creek comes out right there, and then the entrance, or no, wait, yeah, the creek comes in right here, and then there's this big pond back here, and then it flows out right there, and there's huge bass in here. Like I said at the beginning of the video, Chris Boulal has been here a few times, and he has a few videos here catching like 6 and 7 pound bass, so hopefully we can catch at least something. All right, guys, it sounds a little different because I took the microphone off because it died. But me and Josh just got back to the car, and let me just tell you, we walked like 2 miles up the creek,
easily 5 miles altogether.
We walked like 2 miles up the creek, which took forever, and we both got all cut up and nasty stuff all over our feet and stuff, but I slipped. I think I got on the GoPro. I don't know. I'll have to look, but oh gosh. I slipped down a ledge in the side of the creek that I didn't see and like got my phone wet. Luckily, I didn't get this wet, but it was in my hand, and I got my GoPro wet a little bit too, but that was scary. And then we kept going, and then I caught like a nice smallmouth on the whopper popper, and then I caught a largemouth. Josh caught a few good size largemouth and smallmouth today. And then we went to the pond at the end of the creek, which probably shouldn't have done because we didn't catch anything there, but we saw a nice fish on the opposite side of the pond jump out of the water, and it was a pretty good sized fish, but we're gonna have to try that pond another time and find a different way to get there that doesn't take 3 hours to get there. But we just finished walking back on the road, and we're here now. We just came back from across the bridge, and we just got to the car, and I've been carrying my backpack the whole way, which was a stupid idea, and the stupid tripod, which weighs like 10 pounds, and my two rods. So I am wiped. Josh is wiped, but I'd like to thank you guys for watching this video, and stay tuned for the next one. Hit it.